Alrighty guys, welcome back to another video game. Take a look at a PlayStation. Need for Speed 2. I had this game on my PC back in the day and played this game lots. I was supposed to show an intro, but I guess the disc is quite scratched, but it's got a pretty car. One thing I always like about these is a little showcase.
Pursuing its goal of creating the ultimate road-going sports car, McLaren Cars spared no expense and drew upon its vast Formula One racing knowledge to create the spectacular McLaren F1, a super light, high-performance car which employs some of the most cutting-edge technologies and materials in the industry. Built on an incredibly strong and ultra-light carbon composite chassis, the F1's potent BMW V12 engine, producing 627 horsepower, is capable of propelling this car to a stunning 231 mile per hour top speed, earning it the distinction of being the fastest production sports car in the world. For improved grip and handling, the F1 employs a complex system of airflow management, electric fans, and a brake-activated rear foil, whose combined effects literally suck the car to the ground at high speeds. Carrying a staggering 540,000 pound sticker price, the McLaren F1 is the most expensive production road car in the world. But for drivers that demand ultimate performance and can afford the price, few cars can match either its speed or acceleration.
So this always gives you what I liked about Need for Speed on the PC is that you can go to each vehicle and it gives you a little history behind it. That was what I liked. So this car goes 0 to 60 in 3.2 seconds, 0 to 100 in 6.3 seconds, and then it gives you the engine type, horsepower, and all that stuff.
Although founded in 1989, the history of McLaren cars actually began decades earlier, during the outstanding racing career of the late Bruce McLaren. Born in New Zealand in 1937, Bruce McLaren began his foray into automotive racing at the youthful age of 14, when his father gave him an aging 24 horsepower.
So it gives you pretty much the history of it as well.
Pursuing his goal of creating the ultimate road
slideshow. The video. Gives you a short clip, but it's pretty cool. Let's go back and go to the race now. So this one's just pretty much an oval track. There's also a few other tracks you can go, but this is the mostly one I always go to. gives you the most top speed and everything. Need for Speed's been around such a long time. I think the first Need for Speed was on the 3DO.
3, 2, 1, go!
Again, you get a cockpit view of inside the vehicle. It's pretty cool. Graphics-wise, it's what you expect from PlayStation. PC could have slightly better graphics. Need for Speed games. I always had a passion for the Need for Speed games. Need for Speed on PlayStation, PlayStation 2, PlayStation 3, and I'm going on to the PlayStation 4. If you guys haven't checked out Need for Speed Hot Pursuit, I uploaded some videos on that my cousin.com14, and I think I uploaded Need for Speed Most Wanted, I think.
Oh!
Hit that curb again. Definitely check out those videos.
Congratulations, you've got a top time for this track.
Thank you.
So that's Need for Speed 2 for the PlayStation. Pretty awesome game. Check location. Let's go to Outback. Let's go to 2. Not so long. Going old school on the PlayStation here, guys. Gives you the chain of views. Boy, nice. You know, one thing, I didn't have that much practice on this track. Wow, it's going to. Tires on that one. Could have passed some of them, but oh well.
Congratulations. You've got a top time for this track.
Yeah, so that's Need for Speed 2 for the PlayStation. Like I said, I played it on the PC. So, wanted to show you guys that. As always, guys, thanks for watching, subscribe, and we'll see you guys for more videos.